Hi, I'm Whitney Espick, the CEO of the MIT Alumni Association, and I hope you enjoy this digital production created for alumni and friends like you.
Greetings, everyone. I am Pamela Tang, president of MITArchA. Joining me as co-host this evening is Sean Kwok, my colleague on the MITArchA board and MITArchA's Hong Kong representative. On behalf of MITArchA, welcome to the 2020 MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award ceremony honoring Course 4 alumnus, Dr. Ronald Lu, FAIA. We are thrilled to have esteemed guests join us. From MIT, our School of Architecture and Planning Dean, Hashim Sarkis, and Architecture Head, Nicholas de Monchaux. And from Hong Kong, our distinguished alumna, Marjorie Yang. MITArchA was founded in 2015 with the vision to provide a forum in which MIT architecture graduates can connect with each other, maintain ties to Cambridge, and expand their networks within the industry. By extending MIT's tradition of innovation and inquiry beyond the Cambridge campus, our graduates can present the true value of our alumni community to the world. The MITArchA Achievement Award, Alumni Achievement Award, was created to put a spotlight on the distinguished role models in our midst who exemplify these values and this vision. Ron has not only excelled in his professional work, both locally in Hong Kong and internationally, he has been an invaluable contributor to the growing strength of our MIT alumni network and has shown us the power of our collective potential. MITArchA's work would not have been possible without the encouragement and support of our dean and head. And so it is with great pleasure and honor that they are both here today to recognize our MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award recipient, architect Dr. Ronald Lu, FAIA. Professor Hashim Sarkis has been Dean of the School of Architecture and Planning since 2015, shortly before MITArchA was founded. Prior to this, he was at Harvard's Graduate School of Design, where he earned his master's and PhD in architecture and served as the Aga Khan Professor of Landscape Architecture and Urbanism. Dean Sarkis has also held numerous visiting appointments around the world, including the American University of Beirut and the Metropolis Program in Barcelona. In addition to his academic work, Dean Sarkis is principal architect in the Cambridge and Beirut-based firm Hashim Sarkis Studios, where his multidisciplinary projects span affordable housing, institutional buildings, and town planning around the world. He is the author of many articles and books that have filled important gaps in the history of modern architecture and urban design, and has been the recipient of many international awards and honors. Too many to name here. Notably, Dean Sarkis was named curator of the 2020 Venice Biennale, Architecture Biennale, the theme of which, appropriate to our time, asks the question, how will we live together? My fellow alumni and friends, may I present MIT's School of Architecture and Planning Dean, Hashim Sarkis.
Pam, good morning. Thank you very much for your warm and very gracious introduction. I hope you can all hear me okay. Yeah, very good. I may be freezing every now and then. I'll try to get in and out so that it can unfrost, as we'd say, or defrost. Let me try again. One second, one more time. For some reason, the video is weak. I will try again as I'm speaking, if you do not mind. I'm really delighted to be here today. It's very nice to know that so many members of our alumni community could join us in celebrating Ron Lu. I only wish we could all be together in person, but soon I hope. Ron, congratulations on receiving the 2020 MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. The honor is entirely in keeping with your illustrious career and the many remarkable projects you have worked on over the years. It is impressive to note that one of your early positions was at Walter Gropius's Architects Collaborative here in Cambridge. Shortly thereafter, you went on to found Ronald Lu and Partners, which now employs hundreds of people across 5 offices in China. Your and your firm's portfolio speaks for itself. But for me, a few words come to mind in reviewing your body of work: elegant design, refined palette, and a very keen interest in light. Your commitment to sustainable design ought to serve as a beacon, as a lesson for all of us across the architectural community. I trust your work will leave an indelible mark across many skylines and in many countries for many, many years to come. You have come a long way since your student days, and yet throughout your career, you have served in many important volunteer roles. You have generously shared your time and expertise with us as an active leader in the Club of Hong Kong and by serving on the Architecture and Media Lab visiting committees over the years. As you know, Ron, visiting committees are vitally important to the Institute's ability to continue to strengthen our research agenda and pedagogical priorities. Thank you for contributing to our mission this way. You have also been a very generous donor to MIT, and all of us at the Institute are truly grateful for it. I'm delighted to know that your philanthropy mirrors your volunteerism. Thank you for so generously supporting the Institute, including the MIT Hong Kong Innovation Node and the Architecture Department here at MIT. Ron, in addition to the well-deserved MITArchA Award that will be presented to you shortly, I have a little surprise for you. On behalf of the Institute, I want to take a moment to thank you for your support of the MIT Campaign for a Better World. As many of you know, this is the most ambitious fundraising effort in the history of MIT, and the goal is to raise $6 billion. To do that, we have called on all of our alumni and friends around the world to make MIT a top philanthropic priority. Fortunately, we have many generous supporters, including many of you in the room around us today here. But I want to specifically recognize Ron for his commitment with a small gift as a token of our sincere gratitude. Ron, I invite you to open the package we sent you. If you have it with you, it should be marked Package A. Is that it? Yeah. Fantastic. Ron, this medallion features 77 Mass Ave, which has been the public face of MIT since 1938, and where thousands of people climb the steps on a typical day, passing into the infinite corridor and into the infinite possibilities that MIT offers. Fulfilling MIT's mission to make a better world is a team effort, and your contributions have made a real difference in our ability to meet current and future challenges. With your mind, your hand, and your heart, you embody the attributes of an MIT alumnus. And I am really grateful that you are sharing those traits so generously with the Institute. As my colleagues and I at the School of Architecture and Planning consider ways to chart a bold course of action in the years ahead, we hope to continue to attract students from around the world. They will be inspired, Ron, by the example you have set and by the examples of many of our alumni, like those of you here on the Zoom today, who have gone on to have meaningful lives and careers. This is a guiding light as we move ahead with plans to transform a landmark building on campus, which may be very familiar to you, the Metropolitan Warehouse, into our new state-of-the-art hub for design at MIT. It will assemble the Department of Architecture and other school units into one space. The project will reaffirm our conviction that design can bring innovative and iterative ideas to confront today's challenges, particularly as they relate to the built environment and the environment at large. We will have more updates to share with the community soon as we make progress on this exciting endeavor. Ron, it is because of the remarkable contributions of alumni like you who continuously encourage us at MIT to dream big. Thank you again, and I look forward to having an opportunity to congratulate you in person before long on receiving the 2020 MIT MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. Thank you so much. Pam, I turn to you.
Thank you, Hashim. Congratulations, Ron. Sean?
Good evening, everyone in Hong Kong, and good morning for everyone in the U.S. It's my great pleasure to introduce our next speaker, our current head, Nicholas de Monchaux. Nicholas joined MIT last summer, and he is now the professor and head of architecture at MIT. He's a partner in the architectural practice Modem and the founder of the design technology company Local Software. Till 2020, he was a professor of architecture and urban design and Craigslist distinguished chair in the new media at UC Berkeley, where he also served as director of the Berkeley Center for New Media. Author of Spacesuit, Fashioning Apollo, and Architectural and Urban History of the Apollo Spacesuit. Winner of the Eugene M. Award for from the American Astronautical Society and shortlisted for the Art Book Prize and has received other distinguished accolades. His design work has been exhibited widely, including at the Biennale of the Americas, the Venice Architecture Biennale, the Lisbon Architecture Triennale, and the Museum of Contemporary Art in Chicago. He's a fellow of the American Academy in Rome. So without further ado, Professor de Monchaux.
Thank you, Sean, and thank you, Ron, and thank you to all of our alumni joining us all over the world today. Ron was supposed to have received this award at the Los Angeles AA conference in May 2020 with a reception surrounded by friends and colleagues. We regret so much that that event was canceled, but the small silver lining is that I now get to be here as the department head presenting the award, for which I'm actually very grateful. I'm particularly grateful because my journey to MIT was a long one, but the moment in my life where I was considering whether to stay at UC Berkeley or accept a very generous offer to come to MIT as head of architecture actually found me in Hong Kong and Guangzhou and the cities in which Ron has made his professional career this past fall. I was there on a sabbatical trip from UC Berkeley with the belief that this was one of the most important and urgent landscapes to think about urbanism and sustainability that there was. And it was that landscape and a sense of the importance and urgency of what MIT's role could be in advancing issues of urbanism and sustainability that ultimately helped make my and my family's decision to come here to Cambridge. So it's very, it's particularly appropriate in many ways that in one of my very first public acts as department head, I can give this award to someone who's been so impactful in that landscape and thus in the world at large as a member of our community. Also like Ron, I'll note that I grew up in Sydney and came to MIT by a slightly even more complicated trajectory than him. And so we have many different pieces of our trajectory in common. But one of the things that I will never forget that I know Ron has also been a big part of your experience is the disorientation of arriving in Boston, where I first arrived in middle school as an immigrant arrival. And remembering in particular the importance of the support we showed strangers in this landscape. Ron's experience of our department arriving from Australia affirms our commitment to the international diversity of perspectives in our department and our commitment to impacting the world through supporting the most diverse and deserving student body that we can. I've enjoyed saying since I came to the department and have worked with Pam to expand our outreach and engagement with alumni, that our students' graduation is not the end, but rather, as Winston Churchill said, only the end of the beginning. This is our context of our wanting to ensure that we continue to support our alumni as much as possible on graduation, but also a recognition of how much our alumni continue to support us and lead us with their example. In this light, the MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award recognizes the very best in this group and the very best of these contributions. And the selection is particularly meaningful because it's a respectron of the respect you've earned from your peers in our alumni base throughout the world, who are themselves, of course, represent the very best of the architectural profession. I would echo Dean Sarkis's comments in admiration of your support of MIT as a whole and your very deserving receipt of the Better World Medallion. You have supported so much of what we do, from the discretionary fund to our design studio of the future, to the Architecture Graduate Student Aid Fund, and particularly the MIT Hong Kong Innovation Node as well, extending our reach globally. Without this kind of support, we would not have been unable to meet the challenges, priorities, and visions for the better world we're looking to design. Mr. Lu is in very good company receiving this recognition with a short list of esteemed awardees. Established in 2017, the inaugural MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award was presented to Jeffrey Heller of Heller Manus Architects. And in 2019, in honor of the 150th anniversary of the department, the award was shared amongst Ian Pei, Richard Dattner, William Gilchrist, Nico Kenzel, Ellen Liu, and William Pedersen. We are very proud, Ron, to call you an alumni and to signify our esteem for you by presenting the 2020 MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. Now, is there a package B, or do I have just the replica here of the award? Here we go, package B. Fantastic. So, Ron, I'm not letting you off the hook of the in-person event either. As soon as the AIA holds its events in person, as soon as we can do it, we will look forward to celebrating you and your achievements as well together live. But for the moment, let me just extend my warm and very personal congratulations on what is a very meaningful award for me to give to you and to return to you once again when we're able to do so. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicholas. Congratulations, Dr. Lu, on receiving both the Better World Medallion and the MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. Next, I have the distinct honor of introducing Marjorie Yang. Marjorie is the quintessential MIT alum. Her service and leadership at the institute level and in the MIT Club of Hong Kong makes her one of the most respected alumni. Professionally, Marjorie Yang has been chairman of Esquel Group since 1995. Esquel Group is a leading textile and apparel manufacturer with a vertical integrated supply chain from cottonseed research to product retailing. As a strong believer in sustainable development and environmental conservation, Marjorie is a member of the high-level steering committee of the United Nations Global Compact Action Platform on sustainable infrastructure for the Belt and Road Initiative to accelerate the sustainable development goals. And she's also a member of the Advisory Council of China Council for International Cooperation on Environment and Development, CCICED. Marjorie is dedicated to promoting education and innovative technologies. She is the co-chairman of the advisory board of the Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Lab, CSAIL, at MIT. She is an independent non-executive director for Budweiser Brewing Company, APAC Limited, and a director of Sirai Limited, Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation's digital venture for global trade. She has a Bachelor of Science degree from MIT and an MBA from Harvard Business School. While Marjorie is a prominent and established industry and global community leader, it is Marjorie's affinity and deep connection to MIT architecture, her innovative vision and MIT spirit of collaboration that makes her uniquely qualified to introduce our honoree today. May I present alumna extraordinaire, Marjorie Yang.
Thank you so much for that introduction. I'm very honored. I met Ron Lu when he came to MIT for his master's degree in course for many years ago. I don't want to disclose exact dates. Ron believes that as architects, what we contribute to the world is our ability to design better living for all. With this as his core philosophy, after completing his studies at MIT, he established his firm in Hong Kong in 1976, Ronald Lu and Partners, also known as RLP. His mission was clear. It was to build a responsive, responsible, and thinking community of people with the courage to innovate and design a better life. For almost five decades now, RLP has been dedicated to improving the built environment in Hong Kong and beyond, staying committed to improving people's quality of life while setting new benchmarks for sustainable buildings. Ron's definition of great architecture is a building that gives its users a sense of contentment. Over the years, RLP has brought great buildings into existence time and again, using humanistic design that blends seamlessly into the context of the local culture and environment. The strength and success that RLP enjoys today is a testimony to the firm's founding philosophy, its forward-looking proactivity, and its ability to adapt to external circumstances and influences, be these social, political, or economic. Ron cares deeply about community and is especially passionate about addressing some of the most challenging issues facing today's society. Harnessing design to address the sustainable regeneration of urban areas, the integration of health, safety, and wellness concerns into design, and the need to create positive societal change that will resonate in the built environment for generations to come. Under his leadership, RLP designed the first zero carbon building in Hong Kong, the CIC Zero Carbon Park, which showcased state-of-the-art eco-building design and technologies that make people aware that sustainable living in a subtropical urban context can be achieved. Ron cares very much about education. He is famously committed to lifelong learning. He's been learning the violin, practicing Tai Chi. This passion manifests itself in RLP's design of numerous education facilities, including award-winning projects for the Technological and Higher Education Institute of Hong Kong, the redevelopment of King George V School. He also cares about the elderly and is deeply invested in Hong Kong's aging population, designed Tanner Hills, Hong Kong's first non-subsidized quality housing for senior citizens aged 60 or above. Finally, Ron cares enormously about the natural world and our impact upon it. My company, the Escal Group, had the opportunity to acquire a site in Guilin, and we were fortunate to have RLP as master planner and architect. Integral is a sustainable development garden in the sense of the Chinese garden, which is a mini universe and platform for ideas. 40 years ago, Deng Xiaoping made a statement in Guilin. He said, "You must not destroy the natural beauty of Guilin in the name of development." So our joint mission was to create a site where we can showcase how manufacturing can coexist with nature. The eco strategy and human-centric design approach was recognized by Hong Kong Institute of Architects and received the Merit Award at the HKIA Award, Annual Awards recently. The jury of the awards lauded Integral for its efforts to minimize impact on the natural surroundings and context. And perhaps we can bring that philosophy to the Belt Road together. Last month, the American Institute of Architects Hong Kong selected RLP for the Architecture Firm Award 2020, the highest honor the Institute can bestow on a firm. This was the first time the award had been given out in over a decade. This speaks volumes about Ron's incredible contributions to architecture and Hong Kong society. After more than four decades as an architect, Dr. Ronald Lu's philosophy of designing a better life for others has endured and flourished, bringing success to his firm and contentment to the many thousands of people who live, work, and visit his buildings every day. I feel very privileged to have known Ron Lu for over 40 years. And from MIT to Hong Kong, I'm also extremely grateful for this opportunity to pay tribute to Ron on this very special occasion. Congratulations. Pam, I hand it over to you.
Thank you very much, Marjorie. I believe Ron would like to say a few words. Ron, you'll need
Thank you. I think I'm on now. Can you hear me? Okay, good. Well, thank you so much. I'm just overwhelmed with all the kind words and with this fantastic ceremony. And there's so many people I'd like to thank. So I'm very honored to be the recipient of this prestigious award. When you mentioned the list of other recipients, I'm in awe. And to think that I am, part of that small group. So, I'd really like to thank Dean Sarkis, Professor and Head De Monchaux, Maji. I mean, you you said so many things, which is really very, very pleasing for me to hear. And I'd like to thank you for your very, very kind words. Of course, and to Pamela Tang and Sean, who's put this together. I really like to thank you all for all your efforts. At this time, I really like to also say thank my late parents who actually encouraged and supported me during my years at MIT. My dear wife, Stella, who's sitting next to me, and my three children. For when I started my practice, there were very late nights and no weekends. And I thank them for their patience as I was building up the firm. Of course, then I'd like to thank all the dear friends who are here today, zooming in at odd hours from all different parts of the world. So a very, very big thank you for all of you. And, when people ask me, why did you study at MIT? And then I think that I remember as a student, I have a friend whose lecturer was a student of a professor at MIT. That's the professor was Professor Eduardo Catalano. And I heard so much about him. I thought, gee, I really want to learn from him. So, but little did I know that it was actually a two-year program. The first year, of course, was very, very intense. And then most of the credit I was able to complete in 1 year. But it's really wonderful because in the second year, I did a part-time. So I was able to, as mentioned before, I was able to work at the Arctics Collaborative office, which was started by Walter Kropius, and was very conveniently located in Harvard Square. So it was very good. And then the extra benefit of having a second year for me, compared with some of my friends who are in Boston and another university, which is just 1 year, is that having worked in an office, I was able to save a little bit of money, better buy a secondhand car. I was really able to experience and really learn what Boston can offer. And such a thing as, you know, educationally, culturally, work experience, and sports, okay? So I find it very, very enriching to be in MIT in Boston for 2 years. Now, my experience in the MIT is that we had very small class, about 9 students, and the studio was in East Campus, E21. And I believe I was told that what used to be an old chocolate factory. And I lived on the west part of that campus, which is at Ashdown Hall, Ashdown House. And then, and believe me, I have walked those corridors 6 times a day from the east to the west. And so I know those very famous corridors. Now, what I found at that time when I was at MIT was that our studio being very isolated, they really did not have a chance to mix and to know the administrators of the architecture department as well as the undergraduates. And I later learned that there were 2 other students from Hong Kong, John Zhang, and also the late Daniel Hearn was there. And I only got to know them after I returned to Hong Kong. Now, very pleased to hear that MIT has now secured a building called the Metropolitan Warehouse. And that's just across the street from the main dome. And I understand that a lot of the different faculties would be, related faculties would be put in, be housed in that building. So I think it'd be wonderful for that building to be a hub, to be a center for all design related classes. So, and when you ask me, what did you learn at MIT? Now, at MIT, my class was a class that studied system buildings. System buildings is in fact a prefabricated building, which predominantly, was to reduce construction costs. And so I learned with that sort of design that we need to be very well coordinated in terms of the structure, the building services, to make a building very pleasing. And I've carried that philosophy throughout my professional life. So in fact, it was a scientific discipline with a design flair. Now, the most foremost important criteria for me as an architect, besides being having a good education, is actually to have a good client. And they're saying that the architect is as good as the client, and I really fully believe in that. And I'm very lucky that I have had very many good clients. Now, many of them are here this evening. Just to mention some, Jack So, Mr. Jack So, who is now the chairman of the Airport Authority, Abraham Razak, who is our government legislator. And you won't believe it, but I also have a mouse who was my client. Yes, a mouse. Now, that mouse is none other than Mickey Mouse. Now, he was my client when I designed the Disneyland Hotel in Hong Kong. And of course, then Margie. Margie, as she mentioned before, she called me one day and said, Ron, you've done a building, a funny building in West Kowloon. It's called something about sustainability. I said, yes, it's a zero carbon building. And she said, oh, I'd like to have a look at that. I said, sure. So we arranged for her to have a look. And then she called me and said, listen, I have a project that I want to build, and I want to make it an eco-friendly, sustainable, green industrial complex in China. And she very smartly picked a wonderful city of Guilin. And of course, you know, people know Guilin because of the lakes, of the mountains that you see in Chinese paintings. And I know, I think that will be another lecture to talk about that building and my cooperation with Maji. So in all, I'd like to thank everyone for arranging this for me. I'm very thrilled. I won't be able to sleep tonight. But you know, thank you anyway. So thank you very much. Thank you. Over to you, Pam.
Thank you, Dr. Lu. And thank you, Marjorie, for that very inspirational remarks and wonderful introduction of Dr. Lu. We just kind of get brought back in history to understand how important those connections are that we make at MIT and the people that we meet, which is why we always tell the students, you know, don't hide yourself in the studio. Just make sure you wander around and get to know people, because those are the connections that you make that will be long lasting and very impactful on your careers. I'd like to now ask our panelists to pause for a moment for a photo. This is a Zoom type of photo. We're not taking a camera here, but we are recording. And so if you'll just hold your pose and count, hold it for 5 seconds, and then we will transition to the next segment of this program. Thank you everyone for being very patient. We are in the process of moving Dr. Lu's family and friends onto the stage. That is our Zoom screen, so that we can all enjoy a very festive moment together. You will also have a chance to hear from a few of the family and friends of Dr. Lu, and get to know him a little bit more through this lighter moment. Okay, welcome. Welcome everyone to our family and friends segment of the program. I want to especially welcome to our stage Dr. Lu's friends and family, especially Dr. Lu's family, his beautiful wife, Stella, and his children, Bryant, Leanne, and Quentin, and their families. We will now hear from some of Dr. Lu's friends and family. First, someone very special from Australia, Professor Helen Lokhead, former Dean of the Built Environment at the University of New South Wales in Sydney, Australia, Dr. Lu's alma mater where he grew up and was educated. Professor Lokhead, please.
Hello, Ron. I just wanted to, first of all, congratulate you on this extraordinary achievement, and also to acknowledge Ron's early beginnings in Sydney, Australia, and also his time at University of New South Wales, long before I was there. But I have had the privilege of getting to know Ron over the last 5 years, where he's been an incredible supporter and colleague and friend to me as a new dean, not only being a great supporter of our students, but also in being on our advisory council for the faculty, and also being such a great supporter through the Alumni Council in Hong Kong, where we established the Hong Kong Shanghai Urban Lab. So I have been very grateful for Ron's friendship, guidance, and support, and also his contributions to University of New South Wales. So it's just extraordinary to see how far his benefaction and goodwill extends. So it extends from one side of the world to the other. And I'm very thankful that we here in Sydney, Australia, have also been able to benefit from Ron's goodwill, as well as MIT in the US. So thank you very much for inviting me to share this extraordinary occasion with you, Ron. And I look forward to seeing you in Sydney sometime soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Helen. Next, are my fellow founding board members, Jacob Kane and Melissa Marsh. Jacob is immediate past president of MITArchA, and Melissa is our New York representative. Jacob and Melissa.
Dear distinguished guests around the world, Dean Sarkis, Department Head de Monchaux, greetings from Boston, Cambridge. When we founded MITArchA over 5 years ago, we sought to find diverse opportunities to bring our international community together. Beyond the happy hours with current students, gatherings of alumni at conferences, regional events, webinars, the MITArchA board recognized that among our worldwide community, there would be those who have gone above and beyond, pushed the envelope of what is possible, acted as a light showing the rest of us the way toward a brighter future. Dr. Lu, on behalf of our alumni community, we extend our sincere congratulations on your impressive career over more than half a century. Your hard work, dedication, ingenuity, and leadership, your many, many contributions and accomplishments carry on the MIT spirit. They are an inspiration to all of us. Congratulations on receiving the 2020 MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award.
Thank you, Jacob and Pamela. I'm Melissa Marsh, a founding member of MITArchA and graduate of the class of 2004 from the Masters of Architecture program. I've always been impressed by the uniquely global nature of the viewpoint of MIT Architecture program, not one of just educating top-tier designers to make beautiful and heroic buildings sprinkled around the world, but one of seeking architecture as a way to improve lives, cities, and as a form of spatial and social problem solving in a complex world. This viewpoint was at the foundation of my desire to join Jacob in founding MITArchA, a community of alum who continue to express and nurture this throughout their lives and their careers. We are recognizing Dr. Lu in honor of the ways in which he has embodied this spirit of global accountability and problem solving in design, both as an individual and through each of the buildings to which he and his team have contributed. And thank you for sharing some of those today. Thank you, Dr. Lu, for bearing this torch and lighting the way for both colleagues and students and the Institute itself. Your efforts are appreciated. Thank you.
Thank you, Jacob. Thank you, Melissa. Now I will hand it over to Sean, who will continue the program for us.
Yes, hi everyone. Wow, very crowded scene. It's a huge celebration for Dr. Lu. Congratulations again. So please let me introduce a few members from our MIT community in Hong Kong. First of all, is David Wu, our current president for the MIT Club. Please, David.
Thank you, Sean. Hi, good evening, everybody. Dr. Lu, on behalf of the MIT Club of Hong Kong, I'd like to express our heartfelt congratulations on your receiving this year's MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. It is certainly a testament to your many contributions to the field and profession of architecture and your exemplary citizenship, and an honor for all of us as fellow alumni here in Hong Kong. For many, many years, you have been a true friend to the MIT Club of Hong Kong, serving as our past president and currently as an advisor to the club. We are indebted to your service, your volunteerism, and your counsel. We are indeed a proud network of alumni here in Hong Kong, each of us trying to best exemplify how MIT has positively influenced us. Along those lines, you have been and still are one of our torchbearers. May your accomplishments and recognitions provide impetus to all of us here in Hong Kong who have aspirations for greater pursuits and who wish to make an impact to all of us around us. So once again, congratulations on your well-deserved award.
Thank you, David. Let me introduce our past president for the Hong Kong Club and daughter-in-law of Dr. Lu. Lillian, please join us.
Well, allow me to share a bit. I mean, just echoing what everyone has said. I mean, Dr. Lu is just simply an incredible human being and a role model for fellow alumni, and especially for his family, whether it be in his work or his hobbies and his love for God, he always puts his mind and heart into everything he does. His lifelong learning and pursuit of excellence attitudes, his passion to make the world better, his humility and his faithfulness are core values that he inspires in so many of us. He is so loving too and generous with his family and friends, as is evident with everyone present here over this virtual gathering. We couldn't be more proud of you, Dr. Lu, Dad, Ye Ye and Gong Gong. Congratulations on a most well-deserved recognition.
Thank you, Lillian. And with great pleasure, I'd like to introduce Mr. John Zhang, another distinguished alumnus of our course for architecture, also our longest serving financial secretary in Hong Kong and founder of Esperanza, Mr. John Zhang. John?
Thank you. Congratulations, Ronald, on receiving the prestigious 2020 MITArchA Alumni Achievement Award. For this memorable occasion tonight, I revisited your massive and impressive portfolio, paying special attention to recent works like the charming Siqu Center in Hong Kong and the Esquel Integral Campus in Guilin, which uniquely combines architectural elegance with sustainable development. And it is proudly displayed in the background of Ron and Margie. This award is indeed a signal honor and a rightful recognition of your diligence, ingenuity, vision in a productive multi-decade career. Like you, I'm privileged to have been a student of the architecture school at MIT. I'm truly proud of this association, but unlike you, I have not contributed much to reshape the landscape of our built environment. You have made full and constructive use of your learning and you have enriched the world with your designs. So may you continue to produce even more stunning built innovations. Thank you so much. Back to you.
Thank you very much, John. I'd like to introduce our next guest speaker, who is a friend of Dr. Lu's and one of his many clients, Mr. Jack So, who's the chairman of Airport Authority in Hong Kong. Welcome, Jack.
Congratulations, Ron, for this distinguished award. We are very proud of you here in Hong Kong. I remember when I was chairman of the Mass Transit Railway, Ron, you were our architect for many of the large scale developments on train stations as well as around stations. I believe you're also the architect for the hotels in the Disneyland in Hong Kong, to which we have put in a rail extension. In my present capacity as chairman of the Hong Kong Airport, you again is our architect for our headquarters building, as well as the, can you hear?
Okay. Yes, sorry. We can.
Yeah, as well as the Asian World Expo. And I hasten to add that you got all these projects through open tender, not only from Hong Kong architects, but from architects around the world. It just goes to show how well MIT has prepared you for your professional career. Your design is always showcasing a combination of vision, artistry, and utility, for which we are very, very grateful. So again, I congratulate you, Ron, for this wonderful award, and I wish you continued success in building for Hong Kong and for mainland China. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think that concludes all our special guest speakers congratulations to Dr. Ronald Lu. So would you like to say a few words, Dr. Lu, to wrap up our evening?
Yes, well, thank you very much. I mean, this is a evening not to forget. And for all of you to spend all your time here with me and to say a few words, it's really very, very touching. And with your encouragement, I will continue to support MIT and also to try to build even better buildings, and which is more sustainable. I also mentioned that in my year, I think I have a fellow student who's here, Craig Rafferty. I see his name there. So I'd like to thank Craig for tuning in. He's from Minnesota, so it's still quite early for him. Anyway, so thank you very much, everybody. And I really like to visit MIT soon and catch up with Dean Sarkis and also head, Nicholas. Thank you so much, everybody. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. And congratulations again to you and Stella and your family.
Thank you so much.
Thank you to Hashim, Nicholas, and Marjorie for your support and enthusiasm. Thank you for coming today. Really appreciate it. And to all the friends and fellow alumni who are here with us to share this proud and happy moment, thank you. We hope you will join us for future MITArchA events. Sean and I wish everyone a safe, healthy, and happy holiday season. Before we go, I wanted to try something. I've heard that with Zoom now, if everybody were to unmute, we can applaud together. So shall we make a lot of noise as we end this wonderful, wonderful event?
Congratulations. Okay.
Unmute everybody. Stay safe and stay well. Goodbye and thank you.
Bye. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Bye-bye.
Congratulations.
Bye.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
To all the aunties, uncles, and grandpa.
Hey. Thank you.
Bye, and Uncle Joe.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for joining us. And for more information on how to connect with the MIT Alumni Association, please visit our website.